welcome to the cooking portion of my little festive Halloween start off video for my channel. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna do Witch's Brew, which is a cute little drink for Halloween. It's kind of fruity. And the other one is a little candy bar kind of thing, and it is called Halloween Barf. So let's show you what you need and get started. What you guys need for our beautiful witch's brew is you need some straws. I got some cute little polka dotted straws. You need either 7-Up or Sprite. I pick 7-Up personally, but I bought both in case you were a Sprite person. You need a cup. I got a cute little mason jar. And lastly, of course, you need your lime sherbet. Yeah, I just got Publix brand, but really doesn't matter. Whatever your favorite brand is, let's get started. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna open your beautiful sherbet. Oh my god, it looks so good. I'm just gonna, and you take one large scoop and put it in, yeah. And then what you do is you take your 7-Up, which is what I choose, like I said earlier, and you just pour it in. So you're gonna take your adorable straws, like it just be normal straws, and we're gonna try it. Now I haven't had it in a really long time, and it was literally like the simplest thing I've ever had, so good so far. I was expecting it just to be 7-Up, but it's like really good. It's bubbling all over the place. This is good. You should try this. And the witch's brew is starting to happen. It's like getting all green instead of clear. Ooh, this is working. Oh my god, this is so fun. What you need for these cute little bars is you need a spatula to smooth out the chocolate, and all the toppings that I picked were Halloween sprinkles. You could just pick whatever candy that you like, or you could even put fruit in it, I don't care. Little pretzels, I got pumpkin shaped ones, candy corn, and then you need 2 bags of chocolate to make the bars, but I just have it in a cute little bowl. And then I also have orange chocolate chips, and then lastly I have my little Halloween Oreos, and I just thought it was cute. So yeah, that's all you need for it. It takes a little more time, and some parts also need adult supervision, so these take a lot longer than the other ones, sorry. And so you also need some parental help for melting the chocolate, but first step you need to do is melt the chocolate. And I'm not going to show you that because it's going to take a long time to film, but see you guys when we're done melting it. One last thing. There's 2 ways to melt chocolate. The first way is to very carefully do it in a microwave. The other way is to do it on a double boiler. Now, I don't know which way I'm doing, but I hope it turns out well. chocolate in my chocolate. And now after all you toppings, whatever you want to do, you can use white chocolate, do fruit, anything. Like I said, I just used Oreos, orange chocolate chips, candy corn, pretzels, sprinkles, and then after that you can just drizzle a little bit more chocolate on, and that is your brittle bar bark thing. But if you don't want to eat just like fudge, pretty much, you are going to have to put it in this fridge, any fridge pretty much, for an hour to set, and you don't have to come over to my house and use my fridge. Use any fridge you want. So yeah, that's all you have to do, and so yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Here's a tight shot of me doing toppings. Okay guys, so it is now in couple hours later, I'm in a totally different outfit, but we are now here to finish the product. I forgot to film this, but we actually drizzled chocolate over it. This is it before it broke it up. Pretty amazing. And that's what's happening. Know what you do. You just break it up with your hands. Okay, so now that we have our big block, we can just break it up into little pieces like so. And I have this cute little pumpkin box, and on the inside I had wax paper right there. It's kind of clear, you can't see it. So it's food safe and it stays clean. And then we have the nice tissue paper outside to make it presentable. And we can just kind of put them in like a circle like that, kind of overlap them. I mean, you could do it however you'd like. This is how I'm presenting mine. So I'm just gonna cut them up in a bunch of pieces with how strength, something. And yeah, so that's what it's gonna look like. Here's a shot right here of what it looks like. And I'm so sorry that it went over a long time, so I changed my outfit. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave it a like. And for more videos every Wednesday, Saturday, and sometimes Sunday, subscribe. And well, you might not be on an iPad, but I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I love you guys so much. Bye. Oh,